Now I'd like to introduce Peter Malkin. Peter is a music business veteran and a music application expert. Listen carefully because he now will tell you everything you need to learn over the next 2 days as he does his famous video post called Management in the New Digital World. He's doing it now for the first time live. Peter Malkin.
Thank you.
I don't know if any of you had a chance to see this video that I made last fall, but it was really about the frustration of the overwhelming amount of digital tools out there for artists and their teams. So anyway, we've updated it to try to include a few more because it changes so much. So here I go. I know the music biz has been hit hard in the last decade, but there's a new world order out there. You can go to the supposed online biz experts if you want, such as BlazTrack, Star Polish, and Music Biz Academy. You don't even need that Donald Passman book. There's all these tools online that can help you right at your fingertips. This is what you need. First, you have to find the artist. So check Celeband, Slice the Pie, Bandstocks, Kickstarter, and Pledge Music to see what acts fans are investing in. You've also got My Major Company, which mixes traditional A&R with crowdfunding. Then head on over to Our Stage to see what fans are voting on. Of course, you'll have to scour MySpace and YouTube, or use video search engines and video recommendation sites such as Tubify, Fizzy, a music video search engine, and VidiJam. And while doing that, listen to recommendations by internet radio sites such as Pandora, Last.fm, Slacker, Jelly, user-controlled radio, and iSound. Then visit some music-centric online social communities for recommendations like Mog, Bebo, Buzznet, Apple's Ping, and Grooveshark. Then there are sites for aspiring artists such as Boomdizzle, BroadJam, Get Signed, Unsigned, and Music Gorilla. It also wouldn't hurt to go to the sites that allow people to share playlists and recommend music, such as Spotify, Playlist.com, Get Playlist, 8Tracks, Live365, Django, and Ardio. Check SongTweak and Hype Machine for discovery and recommendation via blogs. Use XFM, a discovery service for music blogs that creates playlists for the songs that are blogged to allow you to review later. Or Shuffler FM, which allows you to browse through blogs while listening to featured MP3s. And StumbleUpon helps you find sites more to your interests. Now, once you find the artist you want to work with, you've got to create profiles on MySpace and Facebook, and now you can use Root Music's fan pages to help artists create a profile page on Facebook to sample and buy music. You've also got High Five and My Yearbook if you're looking for a younger audience, Pure Volume and Absolute Punk if you're a rock band, Breakthrough Radio and Beatport if you're a DJ, Plugged In if you're a Christian act, Hip Hop Avenue, Buzz This, and Dope Tracks if you're a hip hop or urban act. Now, updating all of these profiles at once would be a lot easier if you used Artist Data, Meebo, Hootsuite, SkyGrid Groups, Ping.fm, and FriendFeed. Now, we've got to get tools to sell music and products and grow a fan base online. For that, you've got sites like Reverb Nation, Bandcamp, Artistopia, or Indibop. Or, if it's a bigger artist, perhaps Topspit. Bandzoogle is a platform that allows bands to build websites with all the necessary functionality. Digiband delivers a suite of online tools that allow independent musicians to market themselves and connect with other musicians to collaborate and share fans and Section 101. Go to WordPress to create the artist's blog site or Tumblr or Posturus. You may also need to go to RockYou and TagWorld for some widgets, and you'll need Nimbit to sell content through those widgets. The more advanced could use Pringo to help social networks. Echonest designs API platforms that allow developers to create personalized and interactive music apps. MXP4 powers new interactive music solutions for artists, fans, brands, labels, and distribution platforms via social gaming. And Watcha 2 allows lots of people to collaborate in a virtual video environment. FanBridge can help with tools to help manage and engage your fan base. An artist may want to have a mobile app, there you go, on iTunes or Android, so you may want to go to Mobile Roadie, Apiction, Band App, a UK startup that gives artists a platform to create and manage their own iPhone apps, or NetBiscuits. When you build up a big enough fan base, you can consider creating an online fan club through Artist Arena, Spark Art, All Access Today, or Live Nation Merchandise, formerly Music Today. Once music is ready to sell, good luck. You'll need places where people can buy your music online, like iTunes and Amazon, of course, or CD Universe, or in subscription sites like Rhapsody, Napster, eMusic, and 7Digital. You'll need sites such as The Orchard, TuneCore, InGroove, CD Baby, CD Pulse, Iota, or Songcast to distribute music to all the stores online. Of course, you can try and sign with a label to do all this for you, and you can check with A2IM to let you know about all the reputable indie labels out there. You'll need Artist First or Blast My Music to help you sell all kinds of products online. Don't forget Melodio, Thumbplay, and Moses to help you get your music in the mobile space. Now you have to prepare for marketing and promoting your act. If you need outside expert help, I check your biz contacts on LinkedIn. You're going to need to make a video and post it on YouTube. Hopefully it gets picked up by Vivo. You've got PhotoBucket or Kite to help you with all kinds of platforms for your videos. But before you do that, make sure you use encoding.com to enable your videos to work on our mobile and web browsers. You'll want to start virally sending the videos around via email with iJot or Pando. Official FM, formerly Fertilizer, allows you to manage your playlist from one single place. You can create public and private URLs for tracks and playlists. SoundCloud allows artists to create, record, and share music across platforms. YouSend it allows you to send large files, as does Dropbox and MSpot. Then you've got P2P communities that share files, such as iMesh, Kazaa, BearShare, or BitTorrent. Quick note, there are some who believe that these sites are destroying the music business, and others who believe that they help fans sample and discover, which leads to further engagement. Certainly a worthwhile discussion. You might also want to consider making webisodes to help brand the artist and allow fans to get to know the artist. Besides the usual aforementioned sites, these webisodes can live on Current TV, VO, Revision 3, or Motherboard TV, or Funny or Die, Jokeroo, or Break if they're funny. To further brand an artist, they might want to create an avatar of themselves on Second Life where they can play virtually and sell virtual commerce. Or create a ding for fans to personalize their devices. Social gaming is huge. Make sure Zynga gets music into one of their social games. Or CrowdStar, Playfish, Social Gaming Network, Portalarium, PopCap, and MinglePlay. Of course, the artist will have to tour to spread the word. They can use Gig Maven, Sonic Bids, and Online Gigs to help book gigs online. GigsWiz rewards artists for promoting their gigs online and enables the selling of tickets. Better Than the Van is a community of free places to stay for bands on tour. Eventric is a provider of software and online services for the professional live industry, making production of live events more profitable and effective. Use BandMix to help find musicians for artists to tour with. Make sure the artist has a presence in Crowdfire, Songkick, Jambase, Eventful, which allows people to find local events. And I Like, so fans can track the artist while they're on tour. While on tour, the artist should make sure that they're tweeting on Twitter and checking in on Foursquare when they enter a new town, a new venue, a hotel, the bathroom, wherever. They can also use Float, a location-based mobile app that facilitates closer connections. It also doesn't hurt to do some live streaming on the road with Ustream, Justin TV, or StickCam, and perhaps broadcast on sites like Blob TV or Fritocast. Other marketing ideas include putting up songs on WeMix to allow fans to get creative with your songs, or Now Play It so they can learn them. Adara allows you to record live concerts to flash drives, which are available immediately after a performance. JinglePunks allows artists to submit music to get placed. Use CrowdBands to allow fans to vote and participate in a variety of band decisions. You'll also want to generate a PR buzz online. You or your press agent can go to blogs like Koofer, Gawker, Pitchfork, Record Label, Brooklyn Vegan, and Stereo Gum, or magazine sites like The Fader, Paste, and Vice. Eventually, the hope is that the buzz will get big enough to be covered by such sites as Artist Direct, MTV, Yahoo Music, AOL Music, and Spinner. Now that all these tools are in motion, you can track how your artist is doing online via Big Champagne, Rockdex, which presents a high-level view of your artist's online buzz, and Next Big Sound, or use tools from aforementioned sites such as Topspin, Bandcamp, and Reverb Nation. There are many tools that I haven't mentioned today, and I apologize to those I've left out. I did try and update the video since it was made last October with some more tools included. One thing to keep in mind that's really important, no matter what, don't forget, the music has to be great, or I don't know what we're even talking about. That will never change, no matter what the tools for consumption and discovery are. And finally, what might be just as effective as everything just mentioned in this presentation or my video would be to get off your couch, shut off your computer, call some people you know, who always know about up-and-coming music, go to your local venue which features up-and-coming artists, and go out and actually interact with human beings live. Meet people in person, get their instantaneous reaction live, and one by one, build fans the old-fashioned way, direct human interaction. Thank you.
Wow, good. That was hard. Fabulous.